This segment brought to you by Bravo Company USA. Larry Vickers, Vickers Tactical Channel. Today I've got a cool retro AR-15 for you. This is the Colt AR-15 U.S. property marked GAL-5/A/A, or otherwise known as the GAL-5 for short. Now, what's historically significant about this particular clone rifle? This is what was used by the Sontay Raiders in 1970 on that famous raid. Now, they didn't rescue any prisoners, but the impact of that raid certainly had an effect on how the prisoners were treated after that fact. This particular weapon was the Air Force version of the XM-177 series. Colt has brought it to the market, but it's actually being fabricated by U.S. Ordnance. Curtis DeBoard is a serious AR-15 M16 guy. He has a huge reference collection, and he's done a number of retro clone rifles. This is the latest, in a lot of ways, the very coolest. Now, on the original GAL-5, it had a significantly shorter barrel, and this particular device up front was called a moderator. It was actually technically classified by ATF as a suppressor. So it was later had a serial number, and it was registered just like and transferable, just like a regular suppressor. Now, the clone, this is nothing more than a flash hider. It's not a suppressor, and now the barrel is longer. This is permanently attached, and it's a 16-inch barrel, including this flash suppressor. In addition, bayonet lug, of course, was trimmed off because there's really no need on a standard one to attach a bayonet. Go back, it has standard CAR-15 style smaller handguards. A lot of the weapons you see today have the double heat shield, much larger M4 style handguards. This has the old CAR-15 style. You move back here, it has a replica DoD property acceptance mark on this side. The GAL-5 had no forward assist, unlike the ones on the Army side, the XM-177 series, which had a forward assist. Now, it doesn't have a brass deflector, and of course, none of the M16 AR-15 style rifles back then had a brass deflector. Go on this side, you have really good quality replica markings. Also, the selector back here, safe semi-full auto, even though this particular weapon is not capable of full auto. And one thing that U.S. Ordnance did and did a very good job on, they have the selector stops. All right, now, Colt, for whatever reason, never did on the semi-automatic AR-15 series have the selector stops. That's one of the ways you can determine whether a gun's semi-auto or full auto from Colt. One of the great things about U.S. Ordnance, they included that, and if you're a serious retro or a serious collector, that kind of stuff is a home run. All right, moving back here, you have the aluminum style buttstock, which has kind of a nylon coating to it in two positions. It's either all the way out or all the way in. It doesn't have any of the intermediate positions that you see the newer style buttstocks with. M16 or M16A1 style pistol grip. This particular one has a 20-round magazine. Overall, really cool gun. And why do I have such a soft spot for it? Sontay Raid, in many ways, that was the template for what Delta Force does today in terms of security and assault. As a matter of fact, the ground force leader in charge of the assault team, Dick Meadows, a special operations legend, as a matter of fact, they have a statue of him on Fort Bragg, was one of the founding members of Delta Force, and you can see his influence and his imprint on that unit to this day. Really cool gun, chops to Colt, and definitely chops to Curtis DeBoard and U.S. Ordnance for bringing this to the table. We're fixing to light it up for you, Vickers Tactical style, ammo courtesy of MagTech. Stay tuned. Hey, Larry Vickers here. I hope you enjoyed this video. Click here to subscribe to the Vickers Tactical channel and take time out to check out some of our other favorite videos.